Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Welcome to this morning's celebration of the liturgy. We come together each Sunday to celebrate an ancient liturgy, to pray, to connect, and to experience God as community. Today is the first Sunday of Lent, and we have begun our 40-day Lenten journey. We will experience the life of Jesus through these next weeks as we examine ourselves and listen to the Word. Today's readings go all the way from Noah's Ark to Jesus being tempted by Satan in the desert. And through it all, the Word proclaims, "The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel." Sorry for any confusion this morning, but we will not be distributing ashes. Please stand as we greet our celebrant and sing our gathering song, led by the Spirit.
Savior,
and sea and sky, God of all eternity,
hear us, Lord of mercy, Christ of mercy, Lord of mercy.
In our lives. Grant this to our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Genesis. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "Behold, I am now establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, the birds, the tame animals, and all the wild animals that were with you, all that came out of the ark. I will establish my covenant with you, that never again shall all creatures be destroyed by the waters of a flood. There shall not be another flood to devastate the earth." Then God said, "This is the sign of the covenant that I am making between me and you and every living creature with you for all ages. I set my vow in the clouds to serve as a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the vow appears in the clouds, I will remember my covenant between me and you and every living creature, every mortal being, so that the waters will never again become a flood to destroy every mortal being." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Second reading, a reading from the first letter of Peter. For Christ also suffered for sins once for all, the righteous for the sake of the unrighteous, that he might lead you to God. Put to death in the flesh, he was brought to life in the spirit. In death he also went to preach to the spirits in bondage, who had once been disobedient while God patiently waited in the days of Noah, during the building of the ark, in which a few persons, eight in all, were saved through water. This prefigured baptism, which saves you now, is not a removal of a stain from the body, but an appeal to God for a clear conscience through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers subject to him. Hear what the Spirit says to the church.
Thanks be to God.
Into the desert, and he remained in the desert for 40 days, tempted by Satan. He was among wild beasts, and the angels ministered to him. After John the Baptist had been arrested, Jesus came into Galilee proclaiming the gospel of God. This is the time of fulfillment. The kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe in the gospel. My brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
I have something I want to show you, but I have to invite Jetty to bring the camera closer so the people at home can see. Can you come closer to me, Jetty? For Christmas, I received this gift. Someone was trying to send me a message. So I got Old Spice. But I noticed on the box it said, fame, fortune, and glory. Fame, fortune, and glory. And then you hear that whistle. Or something like that. And anyway, I saw this box and immediately I thought about today's gospel, the temptation of our Lord. Because he was hit with three temptations. A temptation that is classic to all of humanity. He was hit with the temptation for wealth. That is the meaning of the temptation, turn these stones into bread. Be an economic messiah. Promote good times, create wealth. And then the second one is fame. Everyone wants to be famous until they are. And so one of the temptations Jesus received from the devil is become a sensation. Have an audience that will be impressed with you. Leap from the precipice of the temple and the angels of God will protect you and you'll become famous. And then finally, glory is on this box. And the glory is the final temptation of Jesus, and that is to worship Satan, and he will give you power over all the kingdoms of the world. So this is the story of the temptation, but we cannot fully appreciate this story without the story of the baptism of Jesus. For at the baptism of Jesus, he receives the Holy Spirit, and the Spirit leads him into the desert of temptation. Reminds me of the prayer of the Our Father, Lord, lead me not into temptation. When the Lord led Jesus, his son, into the wilderness to face temptation. So whatever temptation you experience in life, you can be certain that Jesus already experienced that temptation. And so we have an advocate, we are told, with the Father, one who speaks on our behalf, Jesus of Nazareth, who knows what it's like to be human. When Jesus received the Holy Spirit at baptism, the Spirit led him into the desert wilderness to be tempted of the devil, to do battle, and to confront the spirit of evil that haunts the human heart. And so Jesus encounters the devil in the desert. And the devil comes to him three times with three temptations, the classic temptations that are on this box of Old Spice. Wealth, fame, and power. These are the three temptations that always are at work in the human heart. And so Jesus overcomes these temptations. Now the devil comes to him by trying to raise doubts in Jesus' mind. When Jesus was baptized, it was revealed to him that he was the Son of God. But the devil had doubts about that, and he wanted to spread those doubts to Jesus. So he begins each temptation with the words, "If you are the Son of God, we don't know about that. That may not be true. But if you are the Son of God, turn these stones to bread and take care of your hunger. Create wealth, create financial security." And then he takes them to a temple. He says, "Jump off and the angels will guard you. You'll be famous." And Jesus resists that temptation. And then the final temptation, "If you are truly the Son of God, bow down and worship me and I'll give you all the kingdoms of the earth. They're mine to give." And Jesus resisted that temptation. So each temptation begins with a doubt of his identity, his messianic identity. The same thing happens for us. When we're faced with temptation, the devil brings doubts to our mind. And once we begin to doubt our faith, then we give in to the temptation. This is the meaning of this story. And so as we begin our 40-day observance of Lent, we know we will be faced with all kinds of temptations, but we are not alone. We have an advocate who is compassionate and kind and merciful in Jesus Christ, who's already walked this road before, and now he walks with us through the journey of Lent. And this, I think, my brothers and sisters, is the gospel of the Lord.
Amen.
Shall we stand and profess our faith? Or to pray?
As we begin our Lenten journey, we turn in prayer to God, our Father, asking for his help as we prepare to celebrate the resurrection at Easter.
Our response will be, "Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For the church, that she may be a sign of God's light and goodness in our world, and a beacon of hope for the most vulnerable, we pray. Lord, in your mercy, hear us. For all who are preparing to be baptized at Easter, and all who will be received into full communion with the church, that they will always recognize the presence of Christ in their lives, we pray. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayers. For each of us, we pray, prepare to keep for each of us as we prepare to keep Lent, that we may have a true spirit of self-denial and be content with less so that others may be more. We pray. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all who suffer violence, fear, or desperation, that we be strengthened through the mercy of God and the support of God's people. We pray, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For our brothers and sisters everywhere, that the Holy Spirit will inspire and challenge us to live out our call to be a poor church for the poor. We pray, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all who are sick or suffering in any way, that they will be strengthened by the knowledge of Christ's love, we pray. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
For our special intention this Mass, for the repose of the soul of Jack Chester, as requested by Tom and Tom Myers, may he rest in peace, enjoy the company of the saints in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, we receive your prayer.
Dear friend and mentor, Melanie, who underwent a second surgery for an aneurysm in her brain, that she make a complete and full recovery. For this, we pray.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all of these and all the prayers in the stillness of our hearts, we pray. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, in every age, you call a people to hear your word and to do your will. Open our eyes to your deeds and our ears to the sound of your call, so that every act may increase our sharing in the new life with you, as you offer to all of us. And we pray this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles and to all of us, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace, safely. Please be seated. Thank you. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creations. Your goodness you have this bread to offer, which earth has given, human hands have made, till you become for us our bread and life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, to your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands. For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of God's church.
Loving God, accept these gifts we now offer unto you, taken from the earth and transformed by human hands, into bread and wine for this table. May these gifts be transformed by your Spirit into the presence of Christ. And may those of us who receive these gifts be transformed into his image. And we pray this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hands.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
Father, it is our duty and salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. He is the Word through whom you made the universe, the Savior you sent to redeem us. With the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh and was born of the Virgin Mary. For our sake, he opened his arms upon the cross. He put an end to death and revealed the resurrection. In this he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore we join the angels and the saints in proclaiming your glory as we sing. When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. Gave the cup to his disciples and said, Take this, all of you, and drink from it.
This is the cup of my blood.
The blood of the new and everlasting covenant.
It will be shed for you and for all. so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me.
Let us proclaim the mystery of faith.
As grain is transformed into the bread we eat,
as grain is transformed into the bread we eat,
and grapes are transformed into the wine we drink,
and grapes are transformed into the wine we drink,
we share in your death,
we share in your death.
We offer you, Father, this life-giving bread and saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. May all of us who share in the body and blood of Christ be brought together in unity by the Holy Spirit.
Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Make us grow in love together with all church leaders, especially Peter, our bishop, all your ministers, and all the people your Son has gained for you. Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest in hope of rising again. Bring them and all the departed into the light of your presence.
Remember also the soul of Jeff Chesley, a member of our community here at St. Matt, who have gone to their rest. May he enjoy his journey back to his Creator. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life with Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, with Mark, the Evangelist, Peter, the Apostle, and with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages. May we praise in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ. As brothers and sisters to one another and to the Lord Jesus, let us all pray the beautiful prayer that he gave to his apostles and to all of us, the Our Father. With him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit. All glory and honor is yours, your mighty Father, forever and ever.
Let us pray for the coming of the kingdom as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. As a mother comforts her children, comfort us and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, deliver us from every evil, and protect us from all fear, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior and brother, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Thank you.
This is Christ, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who come to receive him.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed.
And for those of you that are watching at home, we give you this prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the Blessed Sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things and long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come spiritually into my heart. As though you have already come, I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. I think most of you here know the call, but for those of you that are new to our community, we believe that the Lord is truly in this meal of the bread and wine, and if you would like to partake in communion, you may do so. I just ask that everyone stay in their seat, and then deacons will bring you communion.
You may be seated.
us pray. Loving God, may this Eucharist that we have shared strengthen our love for you and for one another, and may it bring us the living water of Christ, so that we may resist all temptation. We ask this through Christ our Lord, who reigns and lives with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And
also with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Are there any announcements? And if we do have announcements, let's keep them as brief as possible. And we'll start with Jenny.
I'll make it brief. I want to thank everybody who participated in our 2021 New Year's resolution drawing. We sold all 100 of our tickets.
Yay!
And the first drawing will be next Sunday after the 9:30 Mass. So good luck to everybody. And if you look in the bulletin, we will be starting March 7th, a clothing drive, if you want to call it that. It's cleanup for the soul and heart of St. Matthew's. And it's a challenge of 40 items in 40 days. So as we go into Lent, clean out your closets. We are taking clothes, linens, anything that are soft goods, purses, shoes. And we will be able to receive 20 cents a pound when we take it to Savers in 2 months. There is an area in the church office that's already sectioned off for these. Bring them in your trash bags, kitchen bags, and we will have donation or receipts because these are tax deductible. Thank you.
Italia? Deacon Italia?
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Once again, I want to talk about the environmental stewardship ministry here at St. Matthew and the class we're going to be offering. There is an orientation class on Zoom. It will be on March 14th, this Sunday afternoon, from louder. Oh, wow, that's good. There'll be a class, an orientation class. It is not a commitment to take the course. It is actually to find out about the course. It's an 8-week course. Yes, there's a lot of time involved, but it is a tremendous amount of information that will touch not only your educational mind, but also your heart and your spirit about our stewardship, our call to be stewards of the earth. And so please let Mariah know, because she's the person in charge of the ministry, the environmental stewardship ministry. And so that we can make sure that you get that Zoom information. It will also be on the website. It will be in the newsletter. And we are possibly going to be putting it on a Facebook, on the Facebook as well. So that's all I have to say this morning. Thank you.
Okay, so I'm going to make this brief. Bible study Monday, Rosary Wednesday, Sunshine Club Saturday. If you do not know about these things, you can follow us on our Facebook and Instagram sites. If you like the way the environment looks in church today, we have Sharon Smith to thank for that. So thank you, Sharon, for your time and efforts. Also love to thank the choir and Mother Jetty for all their work today and every day. So I don't know if anyone who has not been here for Lent, we have a little contest that starts every Lent with peanut butter. So, I had to run in the other room to get a jar of peanut butter, and Tony does not believe me, but there was only creamy in the room. So, all your creamy people, bring your creamy peanut butter, I guess you can bring Chunky too if you want to. But this is a beautiful tradition that was started by Candy Puget, so if... And peanut butter is a sustainable food for homeless and for those in need. So bring your peanut butter for the Lenten season. Also, make sure you keep looking out for the Holy Week schedule. They will be coming out soon, so make sure you mark your calendars for Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, and of course Sunday for the Holy Week masses. So have I missed anything?
I think I got it all. All right. Well, at least my tongue says I have it all. Okay, so everyone, let us go forth now to love and serve the Lord. This Mass has ended.
Thanks be to God.
I heard.